Hello my dear friends, today we will be discuss about the algebraic expression and identity of standard 8 chapter 9 and exercise 9.1. okay, so before going to this exercise we have to remember certain important words. Okay, what are the words? Start one by one. Okay my dear friends, so my dear friends, always I told you before going to any exercise you have to know the what definition of that particular exercise. Okay, what is that? Algebraic expression. We have already studied about what is a expression. Okay, we will discuss. And what is algebraic expression? Algebraic expression is nothing but it is also called a simple expression. What is the meaning of simple expression? If I write here 2x plus 3. If I write here 2x plus 3. We know that 2x, x is the variable and 3 is the constant. Yes or no, my dear friends? If variable and constant will be come together or make a relation with each other, either addition, either subtraction or division or multiplication, they are forming a what? They are forming a expression. So I will say that 2x plus 3 is an expression. Understood, my dear friends? Okay. Now again it is saying that term. The one next one is called term. What is the meaning of a term in this algebraic expression? Yes, very good. That is what? If variable and constant will be coming together, it's form an expression, na? But this variable and constant is called as terms of that expression. Means I will say that 2x and 3 is the two terms of what? Expression 2x plus 3. Understood, my dear friends? Okay. Now remember that. Here again the word is coming as what? Here we know that 2x and 3 are the two terms of expression 2x plus 3. Understood? Okay, very good. Let's go one by one. Next important word. What is that? The next important word is, meaning is known as, factor. What do you mean by a factor? The meaning of a factor is nothing but inner expression. Okay, variable and constants are there, yes or no? But this variable and constants, I'll say that these are two terms. Yes, factors means nothing but if two terms are behaves with each other in such a manner that 2x is the what? If a term I say that, I will say that it is 2 is multiplied with x, yes or no? So I will say that here 2x is the factor of expression 2x plus 3. Okay, or 2x is the factor of, or 2 into x is the factor of term 2x. Okay, here variable is multiplied with 2. Okay, but what about 3? Is 3 is making a relationship with anybody? Yes, what is that? 3 is also multiplied with 1 to form a what? Product of the two numbers, yes or no? Okay, so I will say that the multiplication of two products is what? That one is also behaves as a factor. Okay, okay my dear friends, let's, these are the very, very important words before going to the algebraic expression. Okay, what is that? First one is the expression. Next one is variable, constant. New word is term, factors. Now come to the important point, that is called coefficient. Okay, coefficient. Before going to the coefficient, just tell me, if I write 3x, what are the factors of 3x? Yes, the factors of 3x is 3 and x. And what is the relation between them? They are multiplied with each other. Understood, my dear friends? Okay, very good. Now come to the coefficient. Coefficient of any expression. Or what? A expression. Okay, so let's come one by one. If I will say right here 2x squared. Or you can write here, take 2x. What is the coefficient of x? What is the coefficient of x? I will say that means what is the number it is multiplied or added or whatever it will be multiplied. Okay, especially it is multiplied. Then I will say that that is the coefficient of x. What is the coefficient of x in 2x? Yes, 2. Okay, what is the coefficient of x square? Who will tell me? Yes, very good, 1. Because if I multiply 1 with x square, the result is x square. Okay, and the answer is 1. Coefficient of x square is equal to 1. Next, 3x. What is the coefficient of the 3x? Or what is the coefficient of x? Yes, 3. Understood? Like this manner, you have to find one by one if the given question will be like this. Okay? But before that, if you know the funda, you have to clear it properly. Okay, my dear friends? Let's go another one. What is the next important point? The next important point is called monomial binomial trinomial and polynomial. What is mono? Mono means one variable. Okay, here means one factor, you can say it. Okay, or one term, whatever it will be. Okay, binomial means two factors or two terms. Trinomial means two factors or two terms. Polynomial means one more than three. Okay, or I will say that I can write here more than three. Let's go one by one. 2x, 3y, 4y, 1000. Okay, 1. Okay, these are the called as what? Monomial. What is that? Why? Because only one term here is used. What is binomial? Binomial means if the two terms are making relation between each other, then I will say that what? It is a binomial. Example, 2x plus 1, 3y plus 2, okay, 4y plus 5, okay, or x plus 1000. Okay, means here the two factors are 2x and 1, 3y and 2, 4y and 5, x and 1000. These are called as binomial. Binomial means two terms or two factors. Understood? Very good. Can anybody tell me what is the meaning of tri? Yes, tri means 3. What is that? A plus B plus C. 1, 2, 3 is there. Or I'll say that x plus y plus 1. Okay, or I will write here xy plus yz plus zx. Means here three terms are there. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Okay, then if any expression having three terms, then that expression is called as what? Makeup of three or trinomials. Okay, tri means three factors of that expression, that is trinomial expression. What about next one? Polynomial means what? More than three. What are they? A plus B plus C plus D, X plus Y plus Z plus 1, or AB plus BC plus CD plus DA, like this manner. Means here the terms are how many terms? More than three. AB, BC, CD and A. They are three, more than three terms are there. Then I will say that expression is called as polynomial expression. Understood? So how it is easy, my dear friends. So before going to any exercise, you have to be recall the funda of that exercise so that you can easily solve the problem. Understood? Okay, my dear friends, if you like my videos, then what you have to do? Yes, please subscribe me. Otherwise, if you have any doubt, then write in comments so that I will be rectifying my mistakes or as well as clear your doubts. Understood, my dear friends? Let's go to your exercises. Okay, one by one. Is it understood? Okay. Another thing is also there. What is that? The third, another meaning. Okay, just a minute, my dear friends. Okay, I can say that past word called like term and unlike term. What is the meaning of like term? What is the meaning of unlike term? The meaning of like and meaning of unlike term is what? Just understood. 2x. What is the variable? X, 3x, 4x. If the variables are same, then I will say that it is like term. If I say x square, 2x square, 4x square, then I will say these are called as like terms. Okay? Okay? What is unlike? 2x and 4y. Here the variables are different. That's why I will say that these are unlike terms. Next, xy plus zx. These are two unlike terms. Okay? Means here there is no similarity between them is there. Okay? Though x is there, but here z is different here. So, I will say that if the variables are same, then that terms are called like terms. If the variables are different, then that terms are called unlike term. Understood? Okay, very good. Let's go for the exercise. Understood? Okay. So, what is your textbook? It is there. Let's go to the exercise 9.1. It is there already. The exercise is also given. That is, what is that? What is the coefficient? First, it is saying that identify the terms. They are coefficient for each of the following. Okay. Here, 5xy square, xyz square, okay, and minus 3xy. Okay, my dear friends, now how many terms are there? Yes, very good. Two terms are there. What are the two terms? 5xyz square, another one is 3xy. Okay, because there is no similarities are there. Is there like terms? No. They are unlike terms. Okay. This is the first term. This is the second one. In this first term, what is the coefficient? Coefficient means what? I told you the constant which is multiplied with that particular term. Which constant? 5 is multiplied with this term. Na? So, I will write the coefficient of first term is 5. Who will tell me the coefficient of the second term? Yes, very good, Aniket. It is 3. Understood? Like this one. Why then? Why? Because the variable is xy and 3 is multiplied. So, 3 is the factor or 3 is the constant. So, whatever the constant is there, that one is the coefficient of that particular term. Understood, my dear friends? Very good. Let's go for another one. What is the second one? It is given. My dear friends, I will not do all the exercise. Some of the questions it will for you, you just try it. Okay, if you have any doubt, then ask me so that I will be clear your doubts. Okay, let's go for it. X by 2 plus y by 2. Okay, next minus xy. Now, how many terms are there? Who will tell me? Very good, Sriyans. It is 3 terms. 3 terms. What are the name of the terms? Yes. X by 2, y by 2 and xy. 1, 2 and 3. Okay. So, what is the coefficient of first term? Yes. The constant is 1 by 2. Second one, again 1 by 2. Here xy is there. So, coefficient is 1. Okay. So, it is easy now, my dear friends. Okay. Very good, my dear friends. Let's go to the another one. What is that? Sixth one. What is the sixth one is saying? What is the... Sorry, my dear friends. Okay? Sorry. Okay? The sixth one it is. What is the sixth one it is saying that? The question is 0.3a minus 0.6ab, okay? And plus 0.5b. Who will tell me how many terms are there? Very good, Divyans. It is 3 terms. 1, 2 and 3. Okay. So, first term is 0.3a. Second term is 0.6ab. Third one is 0.5b. Okay. Very good. Who will tell me What are the coefficient of these terms? Very good, Achal. It is, first one is 0.3. Second one is 0.6. Third one is 0.5. Like this manner, you have to find out the terms and coefficient if the given expression. Okay, if the expression is given. Okay, let's go for the second one. What is the second one is saying? Second question, okay? My dear friends, I told you, if you have any doubts, then what? Write in my comment section. Otherwise, subscribe my channel. Okay? Let's go to the second one. What is the second one? It is saying, you certain numbers are given. You have to be certain expression and the terms are given. You have to find whether it is polynomial, binomial, mononomial or trinomial. Okay? So remember that one. One by one I will do it. Okay? First one is saying x plus y. So always remember, you have to find out how many terms are there. Yes. Two terms are there. If two terms are there, then what is that? Yes. It is binomial. Okay? Two terms mean binomial. Next. It is given 1000. Then tell me how many terms are there? Yes. One term. Means mononomial. Okay, another one is given. Let's take 2y minus 3y square. 3y square. Okay, and plus 4 y cube. Okay, now who will tell me how many terms are there? Yes, 1, 2, and 3. 3 means yes, trinomial. This is called trinomial. Understood, my dear friends? Like this one. One means mono, one term means mono, two terms means bi, okay, and three terms means trinomial. More than three, it is what? Yes, very good. It is polynomial. Let's go for the polynomial. It is there. Yes, it is there. AB plus BC plus CD plus DA. How many terms are there, my dear friends? Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 means yes, very good. It is polynomial. Extremely good, my dear friends. Okay, like this manner, you have to solve it in a proper manner. Understood? Okay, very good. Let's go to the third one. What is the third one is saying? Here, he is saying that if the polynomials or binomials or trinomials or whatever it will be there, if they were add with each other, then how we should add it? Okay, let's go one by one. Write down the question and we'll get it. Okay, third one. What is the third one is saying? Okay, let's go to the third one. What is that? One, some of the question I will do it, my dear friends, and rest of the question for you. Okay, if you have any doubts, then what you have to do? Yes, write in my comments. Okay, otherwise subscribe it. Okay. Let's go for it. Some of them are there. Go for the second one. First one is for you. I will read it the second one. The second one is saying that A minus B plus AB, comma, okay, B minus C, okay, plus BC, okay. And the third, it is what? C minus A plus AC. Now, my dear friends, 1, 2, 3. It is a binomial. Which kind of terms it is? Which kind of expression it is? Yes. 1, 2, 3, tri. 1, 2, 3, trinomial. 1, 2, 3, trinomial. How will we add these three trinomials? I will tell you the two processes. Okay, one is the row process, another is the column process. Okay, be careful, whichever is easy for you, you can do it. Okay, go for the one by one, go for the column one. Okay, see what you have to do, write all the first binomial, trinomial. Okay, next, which one is there? B is there, right here, plus. Below B, right here, B plus B, because it is nothing there, means it is plus. Okay, then C is there. It is not there. Okay, it is better that we will be do in a row process. Okay, row it is easy. Okay, let's go for it. Okay, first write it like this one. Plus AB, put the bracket, put plus B minus C plus BC. Okay, plus again C minus A plus AC. Okay, now what you have to do first in the step of simplification, what you have to do? You have to take the bracket first according to the board mass rule. Okay?
Okay.
So first one will be as it is. Then plus means what? Everything will be as it is. BC. Same here. Plus C minus A plus AC. After you open the brackets, bring all the variables or bring all the similar or the like terms in one place. Okay? One A is there. Is there A is there? Yes. A minus A. First, whichever is completed, just make a line here so that no confusion will be there in your mind. Something you are forget to write it or like this one. Okay?
Okay.
Minus B is there, write here minus B. Any B is there? Yes. Plus B. It is over. Next, AB is there. Go for the single term. Okay? C minus C. Any C is there? Plus C. It is over. Let's go to the next one. Plus AB. Is there AB is there? No. So which one is that? This, this and this. What is that? BC plus AC. Understood? Now, A minus A. Yes. Plus A minus A. Both of them are cancelled. Plus B minus B. Both of them are cancelled. Minus C plus C. Both of them are cancelled. Whatever things is there, AB plus BC plus AC. This is the answer you will be get by adding these three trinomials like this method. This is called row method. Understood? Okay, my dear friend. Let's go for another one. What is the another one is saying? The third one, fourth one I will go for it. Okay? I will go for the fourth one. And the two of them, you will do it by yourself. Okay? So, question is L square plus M square, comma, M square plus N square, comma, next N square plus L square, comma, next 2LM plus 2MN plus 2NL. Okay? So what you have to do? First put all them in addition form. Okay, in bracket plus m square plus n square in bracket plus n square plus l square in bracket plus 2lm plus 2ml plus 2nl in bracket. Understood? Now open the brackets. L square plus m square. Before the bracket addition is there. So the expression will be as it is. Okay?
Okay.
Plus m square plus n square plus n square plus l square. Next, plus 2lm, 2mn, 2nl. Okay? Now, what is the next step? You have to be bring the like terms in one place. Okay? And unlike in one place. L square. Any l square is there? Yes, it is there. Plus l square is there. Next, m square. Write it m square. Put it underline. Another m square is here. That is m square. Next, n square, n square. Two n squares are there. Plus. It is over. Then what are them? Rest of them will be as it is. 2mn plus 2nn. L square plus l square. 1n square plus 1l square. It is 2n square. Plus 2m square plus 2n square plus 2lm plus 2mn plus 2mnl. Now, my dear friend, just tell me what is the similarity between these all terms? These are all, if I will write, I will say that this is the polynomial it is formed. What is the common in this polynomial or in every terms? Very good, Saksi. It is 2 is the common one. In all the cases, 2 is there. Put common here 2. L square plus M square plus N square plus LM plus MN plus NN. Like this manner, you have to solve the expression in addition. Okay? Understood, my friends? So, if you have any doubts, then write in my comments so that I will be clear your doubts. Okay? Let's go to the fourth one. What is the fourth one saying? Fourth one saying you have to subtract it. Okay, let's go for the subtraction. Okay, now before going to the subtraction, some of my friends are in doubt. What is that? If it is written subtract A from B, then which one is greater, my dear? Who will tell me? Yes, B is greater and A is subtract from B. Understood? Don't be confused. Means second one is the greater one and the first one is the smallest one. Okay? Don't confuse your mind. Okay na? Okay. So let's go for it. What is the first question is saying? The first question is saying that subtract 4a minus 7ab, okay, plus 3b plus 12 for here, which kind of expression it is? Yes, it is a polynomial expression. Okay, from which one? 12a minus it is given minus 9ab, okay, plus 5b minus 3. Here, if in this case a subtraction is there, means okay. So, you have to do what? I will show you in the two process, that is column method and row method. Okay? Okay, first go for the column method. Okay? Which one is bigger? Who will tell me? Yes, Arushi. It is the second one is bigger, first one is the smaller. So, write the first one first. 12a minus 9ab plus 5b minus 3. Okay, subtract, put here minus. Okay, what are they? It is here, it is what is that? Like term will be subtract from the like term. Okay, all the like terms will be subtract from each other. Okay, not the unlike terms. Okay, if you subtract unlike with the like, that is wrong. Okay, so always remember you have to subtract the like terms with the like terms. Okay, 4a will be coming on below. Minus 7ab plus 3b plus 12. Though it is saying that, remember this one, my dear friends, though it is saying that minus, that whatever the signs are there, it will be what? It will be reverse. That is what? 4a is there, plus 4a, here it will be minus. Here minus is there, this one is the minus, it will be plus. This one, this term, these are all the second polynomial will be changing their signs in the case of minus. Plus become minus n. Here minus become, plus become minus. Okay. Now how I should subtract this one, you just carefully do it. See, how you will study. See, 12 minus 4, because the terms are same, right here a. 12 minus 4. See how again. 12 minus 4. How much? Yes, it is 8. Okay. Plus 8. Or you can say that 12 minus 4a. How much? A is there. Both the terms are same. 12 minus 4 is how much? 18. Direct you can do it. Okay. Okay. Next one. Again, how I will do it? Minus 9ab plus 7ab. Minus 9ab plus 7ab. Though the terms are same, right? It is okay, but here 1 plus 1 minus is there. In the case of addition, what you have to do? If 1 minus 1 plus or 1 plus 1 minus is there, what is the rule? Yes, subtract the number. What is that? 9 minus 7. 2. Put greater value symbol. Greater value is which one? 9. What is the symbol? Minus. Right here, minus 2ab. Understood? Understood? Okay. Plus 5ab See, plus 5bb minus of 3b. Because the variable is b, write it. 5 minus 3. How much? Yes, 2 plus 2. Okay. Now here, minus 3 minus 2a. Because don't read it. Minus 3 plus 2a. It is wrong. Minus 3 minus of 2a. Minus 3 minus of 2a. If both of them are minus, what you have to do? Yes, add the number and put the sign. Put the sign minus 15. Like this manner, you have to be find out the word. Yes, subtraction between the polynomials. This is column method. Let's go for the row method. Okay. So I just erase everything so that you can easily understood, my dear friends. Okay. So that one is a bigger right here. 9ab plus 5b minus 3. Minus of, put the bracket, 4a minus 7ab plus 3b plus 2a. Now take out the bracket. If I would be take out the bracket, whatever the sign inside is there, though they are subtract. So whatever the signs inside the bracket is there, that will be changed to the opposite sign. Means, first try this one. Plus 4a becomes minus 4a, minus become plus, then here it is, plus become minus and plus become minus. Understood? Now in this case you have to what? Keep the like terms in the one place. What is that? 12a, right? 12a. Any a is there? A variable is there? Yes. Minus 4a. Next, which one? Minus 9ab. Any ab is there? Yes. Plus 7ab. Carefully do it. Don't be hurry. Plus 5b. Any b is there? Yes. Minus 3b. And the numbers are there. Right? Is arithmetic. So solve it. As I said, minus between these two cases. A is as it is because it is variable. 12 minus 4, 8. Again here, 1 plus 1 minus is there. What you have to do? Subtract the numbers. 9 minus 7, 2. AB. And put greater value symbol. Greater value is which one? Yes, 9 is the greater value. So put the, what is the sign of 9? Minus. So put the minus sign. Then 7 plus 5. Yes, 12 AB. My dear friends. 5B minus. So that's why I said just underline it. Okay. These two. Variable is B. 5 minus 3, 2. Okay. Then both of them are minus. Put the minus symbol and add the number 15. Okay. So like this manner, you have to be subtract the expression by both column and row method. Whichever is easy for you, you just do it like that manner, my dear friends. Okay. So whenever you will do it in careful manner. Okay. Whenever you are changing the signs. Okay. Okay. Let's go to the another one. What is that? Let's go for the C one. What is the C saying? C is the bigger one. So I will do only one step. Either column or row. Which one I will do? Column method. Okay, go for it. What is that? 4p square q. Then minus 3pq. Then plus 5pq square. Then minus 8p. Then plus 7q. Okay, minus 10 from which one? It's saying that 18 minus, okay, 3p, okay, minus 11q, okay, then plus 5pq, okay, then minus 2pq square, okay, plus 5p square q. Okay, my dear friends, okay, excuse me. Okay, my dear friends. Okay, 5p square q. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. 18 minus 3p minus 11q plus 5q minus 2p square plus 5p square. Always remember, my dear friends, if like this kind of lengthy questions are there, so be careful. All of your data must be present there. Okay. So it's saying that subtract this from this. Then which one is greater, my dear friends? Yes, very good, Aniket. The second one is greater than the first one. So write the second one first. Whatever it is there, just like that one you have to write, my dear friends. Okay. Don't be hurry. Okay. Next, subtract symbol. Put it. Yes. Because it is a constant. Is there a constant is present here? Yes. Below constant, you have to write the constant. Next, 3p. Is there p is there? 3p in the above line? Yes, minus 8p. Okay, like this one you have to write it. Then whichever is completed, put a line so that no confusion is there. Q is there. 7q is there. That is plus 7q. And next one is which one? 5pq. Is pq? Yes. Minus 3pq. Then next one is what? 2pq square. Pq square variable, just find it. Yes, this one is the PQ, variable. Yes or no? So right here, plus 5p square. Because you have to write the like terms in the like term place. Okay. So be careful whenever you are writing this one. Okay. Then which one is left? Is it similar to the last one? P square q. P square q. Yes. It is the plus. Right here, plus 4p square. So the next step is what, my dear friends? I told you. Yes, all the sign of the second expression will be changed. Here minus is there, right here plus. Minus is there, plus, because it is a subtraction. Plus become minus, minus become plus. Only that one you have to rewrite it. Okay, minus, minus. Now read it. 18 plus 10, like this. 18 plus 10 is 28. Okay, next. Minus 3p. Plus 8p. Plus 8p. Don't write minus. Minus 3p. Here. Minus 3p plus 8p. Why? Because the sign is changed to plus. Okay. 1 minus 1 plus is there. What you have to do? Write the variable first. Yes. Subtract the number. 8 minus 3. 5. Which value is greater? Plus value is greater or minus value is greater? Yes. Plus value is greater. So it is plus 5. Right here. 5p. Next, minus 11q minus 7q. Minus 11q minus 7q. Like this one, you can do it rough notebook. Both of them are minus. So, what you have to do? Yes, you have to add the number. 11 plus 7, 18. 18q, put the minus sign. Minus 18. 18q. Excuse me. Minus 18q. Okay. Next, pq is there. Right here, pq, first variable. Plus 5 plus 3. 5 plus 3 is automatically both of them are plus. So directly add it. Okay. Next, variable is pq square. Write it. Minus 2. Minus of 5. Or minus 2, minus 5. Don't read this one because already it is converted into the minus sign. Okay. Minus 2, minus 5. Both of them are minus. What you have to do? Add it. Put the minus sign. Minus 7, p square q. Then what is the variable in the last one? P square q. Okay. Plus 5, plus 5, minus 4. It is plus 1. Or p square q. Okay. Like this manner you have to be solved the given expression if it is add and if it be subtract. Main thing is what? Like terms will be subtract with the like terms and unlike will be as it is. Okay. So like this manner you have to be solved the polynomials in the this method. Okay, my dear friends. So always I told you, remember the funda. And
clear your doubts.
Okay? And solve it properly. Okay? Nothing is impossible for you, my dear friends. So, my dear friends, if you like my channel, then please subscribe it. And if you have any doubts, then what you have to do? Yes. Write in my comments so that I will clear your doubts. Okay? Thank you. Have a nice day.